Welcome to another episode of Telecom Terminologies video series, which talks about telecom terms. So today's topic is CDMA 2000. CDMA 2000 is a third generation 3G technology, just like UMTS and the GSM networks, and it has been mostly deployed in the US and some Asian countries, and not so common on the European side, so not so common in the UK. Well, not at all common in the UK. So let's dive right into this technology and learn all about CDMA 2000. CDMA 2000 is a mobile network technology that delivers 3G services using code division multiple access, CDMA. It is also known as IS2000 or CDMA 2000, 1x RTT, radio transmission technologies. CDMA 2000 is a successor of IS95, which is a second generation technology. So CDMA 2000 is 3G and IS95 is 2G. CDMA 2000 delivers 3G services as per the specifications in IMT, International Mobile Telecommunications 2000. So this is a global standard for 3G services. At launch, CDMA 2000 could enable peak data rates of up to 153 kilobits per second. For 2G and 3G networks, there have been two main tracks for mobile network evolution, the GSM track and the CDMA track. So these are the mobile network tracks. CDMA 2000 is a 3G technology on the CDMA track. Let's now have a look at this table that shows all the key network technologies that have been used for the different generations of mobile networks. As you can see, CDMA 2000 is one of the key 3G technologies, just like UMTS. Let's now have a look at this table, which may look a bit busy when you first look at it, but let's go through these rows bit by bit to understand it clearly. So one of the best ways to learn about a new technology is when you compare that with an earlier technology, and that's what we will do here. We'll compare CDMA 2000 with IS95. So if you look at the second row, the technology standard that defines CDMA 2000 is IS2000, Interim Standard 2000, just like CDMA 1 is IS95. And that is because IS2000 was introduced in the year 2000, whereas IS95, as the name suggests, was introduced in 1995. CDMA 2000 is backwards compatible with its predecessor IS95, making the upgrade from IS95 to CDMA 2000 easy and seamless. The bandwidth of each channel or carrier is important because that is what gives you higher data rates. In IS95 or CDMA 1, the bandwidth was 1.25 MHz, but CDMA 2000 is able to aggregate up to three 1.25 MHz channels to get a total bandwidth of 3.75 MHz. Just for comparison, in UMTS, which is the GSM version of 3G, you generally get a bandwidth of 5 MHz. So UMTS has flexible bandwidths as well, but 5 MHz is the general or most common bandwidth that is used. CDMA 2000 networks can operate in both 850 MHz and 1900 MHz frequency bands, just like the earlier IS95 networks, with separate frequency bands for uplink and downlink. The uplink in CDMA is called reverse link, and the downlink is called the forward link. CDMA 2000 has seen several enhancements, including CDMA 2000 1x EVDO, Evolution Data Optimized, CDMA 2000 1x EVDV, Evolution Data and Voice, and CDMA 2000 3x RTT, which is 3x radio transmission technology, which means three carriers are used. 1x RTT can support peak data rates of 153 kilobits per second in the downlink and the uplink. So 1x RTT means one carrier or 1.25 MHz is used. And finally, with the EVDO revision B enhancement, CDMA 2000 can support maximum data rates of up to 14.7 megabits per second. Before we finish, let me take you through one more concept. The networks before CDMA mobile networks were using a combination of FDMA and TDMA for radio transmission. So that is what GSM and DMs networks used. The challenge with that is the potential interference caused by the same or adjacent frequencies. These interferences are called co-channel and adjacent channel interference. As a result, when RF engineers are planning the cells, they make sure they reuse the frequency channels carefully to ensure that when they assign a frequency channel to a cell, they avoid using the same or adjacent channels in the neighboring cells. Now, CDMA networks do not have the frequency reuse limitation, and they use the same frequency carrier or channel in all cells. Unlike TDMA-FDMA-based networks like GSM and DMs, where handover requires a mobile phone to disconnect from one cell before connecting to the new cell, CDMA networks use a concept of soft handover or handoff. Since CDMA networks use the same frequency across all cells, a mobile phone can communicate with multiple cells simultaneously. As a result, the mobile phone can gradually disconnect from the cells that are no longer in range whilst staying connected to other required cells. Soft handover makes the handoff process more robust, making it less likely to drop the calls.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. I've written a detailed post on this topic, and the link is in the description. Thanks for watching.